Hey, what up, everybody? It's Senny, and this is Bloodborne for PS4. And this time, we're gonna continue in the Forbidden Woods, part 12. We are at the shortcut here. I was looking for it last time, and couldn't find it before I ran out of time. So I went ahead and found it. So at the beginning of this video, it's going to be about 5 minutes of me showing the shortcut and a couple other things, and then we're going to go into some live commentary for you for the rest of the video. But this here is post commentary of me finding the shortcut that we were looking for at the end of the last video, which is right here. You have to totally leave that area, and right outside is the elevator. Wasn't the one I was looking at. I think that one's later on. Get some antidotes. Here's a spiffy dude we can talk to.
Ah, a new face, are you? And an accomplished hunter, it would appear. I am Volta, master of the League. Members of the League cleanse the streets of all the filth that spread about during the hunt. Like any half-decent hunter ought to, you know? You've seen enough of these wretched beasts, freakish slugs and mad doctors. Sentence these fiends to death with the help of your League confederates. What do you say? Why not join the League?
Sure, why not?
Yes,
Join the
as
League.
A hunter well should. Commit this to heart. Our own Carol Rune, symbol of the League.
Impurity.
The night brims with defiled scum and is permeated by their rotten stench. Just think, now you're all set to hunt and kill to your heart's content. Hunt in cooperation with your fellows, your League confederates.
Okay, so you gave us a rune. That's cool.
No, there is one thing you must know. By the oath of the League, those who bear its rune will see vermin. Vermin writhe deep within all filth and are the root of man's impurity. All vermin are to be crushed. The League exists to expunge all vermin, ridding us of any trace of human corruption. And so, until we are rid of all vermin, you must continue to hunt and kill. This bloody fate is ours alone. Do not expect the world to grasp our work. But remember, the Confederates will always have my blessing and each other. Always.
Okay, volunteer.
The League exists to expunge, and so.
I think he's saying the same shit again.
Not expect the wand each.
So, it's like a covenant, I guess. And he gave us a rune. Let's see what he gave us. A Carol rune. It goes in the last slot, so we've been looking for one of these. They must be the covenant rune slot there. A Carol rune that transcribes in human sounds. This rune, discovered inside the forbidden beast eater, came to symbolize impurity and the oath of the League. Confederates of the League cooperate with hunters from other worlds and hunt to discover vermin. Vermin writhe within filth and are the root of man's impurity. Crush all vermin without hesitation. So I don't remember exactly how the League works. I know you cooperate with other League members to kill certain things, but I have never done it. So I'm not exactly sure, but it's kind of like a covenant. Kind of like the Forest Hunters, maybe, something like that. Yeah. So, if you want to check it out, check it out. I am playing offline for now, so I don't think I'll have to deal with it. And I don't know if the rune does anything. I'll have to look it up. I think it just, you put it on and then you're called to fight vermin whenever another one of your League Confederates needs you to, or whatever. So, it like calls you to do special, online stuff, I guess. So I'm offline, so it probably won't do anything for me, but I'll have to look up and see if it has any extra stats, maybe. Anyway, that's it for the first little part here. Next thing you're going to hear is some live commentary.
Peace.
Hey guys, thought I would try some live commentary this time. We're back at the shortcut. Talk to this guy. So like the first 5 minutes of this video is post commentary because I wanted to show the shortcut. We had ended last time. Last time when we ended, it was pretty close to the shortcut, but I was running out of time. So I had to show the shortcut at the beginning of this video. And now we're back here in the Forbidden Woods. I got this new set on. Let's check it out. And it's over here. Ashen. Where is the hat at? Great. What a cool way to start here. Here we go. A mask made of bone ash worn by the oldest keepers, the keepers who mined the slumbering great ones, gained eternal life, preserved in ashen form in a ceremony of flame that cremated body and soul. The long pointed hat is a symbol of the old keepers and is considered evidence of their companionship forged in a certain sin. Now their frail armor is white and sinewy, a window into an arcane lost art. Gauntlets made of bone ash worn by the oldest keepers. Leggings made of bone ash worn by the oldest keepers. Let's see how good it is here. Pretty high physical defense. Physical and fire. And bolt. So, good for fire, bolt, and physical defense. Got that because I've been doing a lot of chalice dungeons off recording. Twin bloodstone shards, nice. And I fought a boss, looked like this. One of the bosses did, so once I beat him, I could buy this with insight in the insight shop. Which way should I go? I can drop down here. This is the way back to where we were, which I don't think I got everything in there, so let's go back. Let's go back here first, because I think I may have missed some stuff, and if I didn't, we'll check it out anyway. Give this guy the old backdoor treatment. Those guys are dangerous, the snakehead dudes. So watch out for them. They can take out your health in a very quickly, a couple hits. Another thing I wanted to show is this. I got the Uncanny Saw Cleaver +6. It has 160 physical attack. So it's better than my other one. It has different gems in it. It's got a arcane gem or a triangle gem. So I was able to put some better gems in it, so I'm gonna go ahead and use the Uncanny Saw Cleaver instead of the normal Saw Cleaver. Pretty much the same thing, just different gems. Let's get out our torch. Make sure we got everything in here, because I'm not 100% sure we searched. I think I was kinda looking for just the shortcut when we came in here. Why do I not have my weapon out? That's weird. What is going on? Did I take it off? Oops. Put that back on. Okay. Alright, got our torch out. Gonna look around, make sure we didn't miss anything. Make sure we got the cannon. See? Here's the snake, guys. That's what happens when it explodes out of their head. They look normal at first. And then all of a sudden, they aren't normal. Ooh, jeez. Alright. Gotta get used to playing this game again. Kinda took a little break and played some other games. Usually it's Dark Souls 2 that screws me up with Bloodborne, because the buttons are really similar, but kind of different. But I haven't even been playing any Souls games lately, believe it or not. Mostly just some other games on the channel, if you want to check them out. And I'll never abandon Souls, even to my own detriment. The channel's kind of getting better and better right now, which is good. Mostly due to other games on the channel. But that won't affect Souls, man. My heart is with Souls games. So these are not going away. If you're here for Souls... Alright, it's back where we started. If you're here for Souls, then don't worry about it. They're gonna still be coming. I'm just gonna have to share my time with these other games a little bit more equally, at least. Instead of putting out like 3 or 4 Bloodborne videos in a row, I gotta kinda share and do turns with the other games. Just because they're getting so many views and subscribers and stuff. I know that Souls is not... Alright, that's the cannon guy. We don't need to come out here. This is where we came in. Let's make sure we got this item. Yep, got it. Need to make some progress. I probably shouldn't have went backwards. But there's an item right there I missed already, so I need to go get that. Wonder how... Isn't there a ladder or something in here? I thought live commentary would be a little better, just that way I don't already know what's going to happen. Even though I've played these games, this is at least my 3rd time through this game now. But, can I drop down here? Not sure if I needed to do that. Oh, here's a dude. Let's get our gun back out. Too late. Too late again? Man, my parry timing is way off. I just did a bunch of Chalice Dungeons, so I was like on point with this game for a while there, and now I'm rusty as hell. Alright, I thought there was something else out here. Let's look around. There's a big old... Oh, that's Bergenworth down there, by the way. And you can probably see where you're gonna fight the Shadows of Yharnam, too. If you look down there. Let's climb the ladder. So what was I saying? Yeah, Souls will never go away. I'm gonna keep playing it. We're definitely gonna complete this playthrough. And then I got remastered to play, and I need to buy Sekiro once it comes out. March 22nd, I think it said. I think they just confirmed that like a few days ago, I saw on Twitter. I'm playing this playthrough on March 5th. I don't know when it'll come out. Hopefully March 5th, but it might be 6th. Poison knives. That's a clue for here in a second. I thought there was a cannon. Do I already have the cannon? Oh, is that it? I think that's the cannon down there. Let's talk to the afflicted beggar first. Okay, anything else out here? Poison knives, once again, another clue. Check this guy out. I hope my sound's not... Let me check my sound. I haven't... Did that turn up everything too much? That should be fine. Alright, so check this dude out. We got blood everywhere, first of all. We got a corpse, another corpse, and there's a corpse right there if you can see it, and he seems to be munching on it. He's eating with his hand. He's kneeled down. Looks like he's eating the corpse, so he's a cannibal, first of all. And this body's actually, not... You know, they're actually there, you know what I mean? Usually you can walk right through bodies. They're kind of stuck as like a set piece, huh? Alright, let's talk to him. We've caught him doing something. We caught him with his pants down. it's late at night and we're his mom bursting into his room and he's like, oh shit, oh, I wasn't doing what you thought I was doing.
Whoa, blimey, don't scare me like that. On a night like this, I took you for a monster. Oh, thank the stars, you're fairly normal. Was it you who put down that awful beast? Ooh, that thing had me trembling, frozen in me boots. And then you came along. Well, if you were a hunter, then would you know of any safe havens?
Alright, so this is the guy I told you guys about earlier. He's the guy that will go in wherever you send him and he'll start killing people. He's really a dark beast. He'll transform, he'll start killing people. You can see he's eating people here, so you that should be your clue that he's not a very good person. So just like Law Trek or the Silent Chief or whatever, he'll start killing people at your hub. If you send him to, the worst place to send him is Uden Chapel. Yusefka's Clinic's kind of interesting. I've done that before. He'll go in and he'll kill everybody in there. Or I can't remember exactly what happens, but it's kind of cool to send him to Yusefka's Clinic. But we're going to withhold information this time. I want to show you guys how when he transforms, and let's fight him real quick. Show you how to deal with him easily.
Oh yeah, of course not. I should have known. This whole place is falling apart once again. It's the curse of Yharnam.
Yeah, I don't know where to... I don't know any good places, man. Sorry. I only got my card on me, dude. I can't loan you any money.
Oh, you again. You find any nice, cozy places to hole up in?
No, I still haven't, man. Sorry. Nowhere to go.
Oh, yeah, of course not. I should have known. This whole place is falling apart once again. It's the curse of Yharnam.
Right, right, right. So, yeah, don't send him to Uden Chapel unless you just want to see everybody die. He'll kill everybody there. Except for, like, the first guy. I don't know. He might kill everybody. I can't remember. But, so we're gonna go ahead and give him a nice little loving from behind here. Hold on, I need to put something. Alright, I got poison knives. We're gonna use those. Alright, let's do this. Let's heal up. This guy hits hard.
Have you got a screw loose? Or is it your animal intuition? You hunters have got more blood on your hands.
Right here? Now he can't get you. He's too big to fit through the hole. What's up, bro? Come get me. Come. Oh, you can hit. He's got a little bit of a projectile there. Alright, so here's what you do. He's very susceptible to poison. I hit him with the poison knife, and he's already poisoned. I'm gonna hang back a little. I don't want him to hit me with that thing. Whoa! Look at that. Look at all that damage. Holy crap. That's a weight. I don't want to use up too many blood vials, but... Let's see if we can get our monocular. Yep, we got it. I'll get as close as I can. Stupid hat's in the way. But there he is. Looking all scary. Trying to hit me with that ranged attack. Looks like we need to re-poison him. Alright, let's get off the monocular now. Stop it. Alright. Still getting used to the buttons again. I should have ran through a chalice dungeon before I recorded this video. Another poison.
Die. Hunters are killers, nothing less. You call me a beast? A beast? What would you know? I didn't ask for this.
Well, I'm not a beast. You're a beast. I'm just a hunter. I might be like a ruthless hunter, but I'm not a beast. But yeah, you can try to fight them one-on-one out there, but it's pretty tight quarters. You can fall off, and you see how hard he hits. He can kill you in 2 shots. Wow. Almost still knocked me off. I don't know if I'm gonna heal that. Here, let's do this. And we healed a little bit with that. Alright, one more poison knife. And that should do the trick. So yeah, you don't want that guy in your chapel. It is kind of fun to send him to Yosefka's clinic, but you don't really get to see him killing people. You just see like the aftermath of what happens. And Yosefka might get the better of him, I'm not sure. Alright buddy, no more ranged attacks. Yep, you are. You're a rancid beast. You're eating people over here. Beast rune. I think that's the one that gives you more, well, let's check it out before I say the wrong thing. Beast, yep. Temporary boost to transform plus 50. Wow, that's 30 more. We need to put that junt on there. That jant. Put that jant on. You can put 2 of them on too. So we could have plus 80 or something. Because you can stack runes. You could put 2 runes on that give you blood vials and get extra blood vials. You could put, I don't know if there's 3 of them, but you can at least do 2. Let's drop down and get this cannon here. Hold on, let me see. Make sure there's nothing over here. This is where we climbed up, right? And we went across. There's something to the right there. I think the cannon. And we picked up something there, and we went up here, fought him. Okay, so let's drop down over here. And this is the cannon. The cannon. The cannon. Alright. So I want to get the stats for that beast. La 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 la, the cannon. Let's check it out. Where the hell is it? Right there. What do we need? 30 strength, which we have. And 13 skill, which we have. So we could probably equip it. I have to get rid of my gun or my torch. Let's do the gun for now. Somebody is texting me. I am sorry. Okay, there we go. Let's put the cannon on. That'll be fun. It does use quite a few bullets, but if you put on your runes that give you more bullets and you use blood bullets, you should be fine. Let's see if there's anywhere else to drop down before we progress with Forbidden Woods. I don't really see anything. Nothing else up here. This is kind of a new spot. Let's make sure there's nothing up here. No. Can I drop down? Yeah, so I think live commentary is a little bit better sometimes. It's just based on, like, my environment. I know I've said this a million times, but I can't record all the time. It's pretty loud in my household. Let's see if we can make that. Ooh. That was crappy, but we still didn't die. It's pretty loud in my household. So it's hard to record. So I usually have to, like, record the video first of me playing through the area, and then I'll have to record the audio after. Like late at night when everybody's sleeping and there's no crazy interruptions, which could still happen right now. Let's see here. I got to keep my timer going. Make sure I don't go over, because I've done that recently too. All right, should we go to the right or to the left? I kind of want to try doing Frenzy Cold Blood. That's pretty much just echoes. I want to try to do the shortcut, the speedrunner thing they do, where they hop straight to Shadows of Yharnam, pretty much. I'd like to try to do that, but let's just go right here, see where this takes us. We'll follow the right wall. We'll do right wall strats. Ooh yeah, what a good jump. Ooh, don't fall. Alright, so we're up here. Let's try to make this jump now, if it is a jump. Alright, made that one. Right wall strats in full effect. I haven't seen very many Souls channels very active lately. I know they're all going to come out of the woodwork when Sekiro drops here in a couple weeks, but I guess nobody really, you know? You think there'd be a more of a... Holy shit. Let's get out of here before he does that again. I heal up. Well, let's try the cannon on this guy. Do I got it out? Nope. Oh! Huh? I wanna shoot it. You wanna hug? Holy shit! I need to switch back to my gun. So you need 10 bullets to fire this thing? How much? Darn. Stop it. Looks pretty cool though, huh? Did we read the description? No, I likes to read my descriptions. No, come on. Large prototype firearms fashioned by the workshop heretics, the powder kegs. Use of this weapon is equivalent to toting a mounted cannon. Complete with its ridiculous weight, staggering kick, and lavish use of quicksilver bullets into battle. Such a monstrosity was doomed from the start, and indeed its development was cut short. Yet against impossibly gigantic foes, it might be just the thing. And I've encountered some foes that have cannons in the chalice dungeons. Alright, we better take this thing off. Used all our bullets up. Go back to the hunter pistol for now. I said I was going to use more different guns. Since I was keeping the same main hand weapon, I was going to use a saw cleaver the whole time, which I've pretty much done. I think I've done just 100% done. As far as guns, though, it's been kind of hard to get off the hunter pistol. I really like it. But I've used the flame sprayer and the cannon. There's a spot where you can jump up and skip the whole level, but I didn't watch the video before I started, so I guess we're not doing that. Let's just keep doing right wall strats here. I wonder if there's a spot you can drop down anywhere that's a good spot. I probably shouldn't be so meticulous. Is that a little spot? No? Alright, that's... Nope. Okay, so let's just keep going this way. We'll just stick with the right wall strategy. I guess we're exploring all of Forbidden Woods. I've been really grappling with myself about whether to just speed through the game or take my time. I kind of been doing somewhere in between, which isn't very... not a very good thing, in my opinion. I think I should be either all in or all out on one or the other, but it is what it is. Those little snake guys are pretty easy, unless you're fighting something else and a couple of them gang up on you. It's the big ones that you need to worry about, not the little ones. I need to do transform attacks. Uh-oh, snake boy's coming. Snakehead. Let's grab this item. Twin Bloodstone Shards. So this is where you start getting a steady drop of Twin Bloodstone Shards. We need chunks, though, not We really do need chunks. Let's try to get rid of the snake before this guy gets on us. Yeah. I don't got that many bullets, bro. Stop it. Alright, now I got 9 bullets. Wow. Come on. Gotta love that transform attack. Dropping pretty good soul echoes. Alright. Let's get our torch back out. We can see better. Some more lake. I think that's where Rom is. Maybe not that specific part of the water, but body connected to that is where Rom is. See, these things are slow. They barely ever get an attack off. If you just take care of them quickly, not a huge deal. I've also been going back and forth in between, like, doing a walkthrough and just doing, like, a commentated playthrough. So, I don't know. Just my first playthrough. It's kind of anything goes type shit. That way. You saw me kill your buddy, and then you just stood there and waited for me to kill you, too. Blood all over the grass. Alright. Keep the right wall strats going. Hopefully we don't find something too nasty. I know there's a few things we want here in the Forbidden Woods, or else I would totally... Oops. Fuck me. Fuck, dick, lick. I guess I curse a lot more when I'm doing live comms. Sorry about that if you're offended. Blood vials. This guy just wants to get killed. There's his buddy. He wants to die too. What was I saying? Yeah, in the Forbidden Woods, there is a couple really good runes. We just got one. It's not that one. That one's good too. We've probably gotten we're going to end up getting 3 or 4 good runes from this area. Not to mention all the twin bloodstone shards, for example, right on time there. The beauty of live commentary, nice coincidence there. But yeah, there's good runes in here, and there's a cool set you can get. It's like I forget what it's called, it's like a grave digger set or something. It's not called that, but something along those lines. It's pretty cool. It's like another. It's kind of like this one, but it's red and it doesn't have the witch hat, and it has like a hood, and it's red. It's like the red version. It's really cool. It's kind of hidden in here too, so hopefully we can find it before we... Oh, here's the big snakes. Here we go. He's gonna spit at us. I remembered that right at the last second. Alright, gonna keep spitting. How come you're doing all the work? You got so many friends. Alright, let's just run around behind him. Oh, great job. Great job, Senny. Way to go. Oh, sweet, sweet, sweet. Damn it. What the fuck? Alright. What should I do here? Spitty Spitterton just wants to spit. There we go. Fuck that guy. Bloodstone shards. Those are crappy at this point. Twin bloodstone shards, that's more like it. I'd rather have chunks, but twin bloodstone shards are like not an insult to my intelligence here. Like a bloodstone shard, come on. I got like 100 of those right now. I should just level up everything. I think I did, so I probably don't have 100 of them, because I think I leveled a bunch of my weapons to like +3 or something. Just for the hell of it, because I had so many. Thick coal bud, more echoes. Not like I need it because I been doing so many chalice dungeons that I'm not over leveled, but I would say I'm borderline. We just got another rune. Let's check it out. What am I? 71. I've seen people play this area around 50, 60. So I'm about 10 levels too over leveled, but that's what happens when you do chalice dungeons. And you get cool ass shit in the chalice dungeons too. So let's check out that rune. This place is awesome for... Yeah, check all these out. Thimeru Chalice, Thimeru Root Chalice, Thimeru... Central Thimeru Chalice, Central Thimeru Root Chalice, Lower Thimeru Chalice, Hintertomb, Hintertomb Root, Lower Hintertomb. I got like almost all the ones that you can get at this point in the game, I think. Not 100% sure if that's the truth, but it's pretty close because I've done like all of them almost that I can do. Which one did we just get? Clear Deep Sea... A secret symbol left by Carol, runesmith of Bergenworth. This transcription of the Great One's inhuman voices depicts downreaching currents. This rune means deep sea and grants augmented resistance. Great volumes of water serve as a bulwark, guarding sleep and an auger of the eldritch truth. Overcome this hindrance and seek what is yours. Ah. So that gives you resistance, 100 to everything. That's a badass rune. I'm going to put that on. Soon as possible. I like to use defensive runes. Just like passive shit is like my thing. Anything that I can take advantage of without having to do anything, for some reason, like is a thing, you know, gets me going. I just like perks that happen without me having to trigger them. Like, hey, now I have 100 resistance to everything. I don't have to, I don't know. They're pretty much all passive, but that snake can see me, clearly. Why doesn't he tell his host? There's at least two snakes there looking straight at me. And this is going to be a bitch once I set this off. Oh, I'm so dumb. I meant to transform it. That was dumb. Shiny coins. Holy shit, that was a lot of damage. Now I'm trapped. Oh, thanks, buddy. That's great. Somehow you grabbed me like that. I don't know if jiggling the shit helps, but... okay. And heal. Can't believe we got out of that one. Alright. Nope. Holy shit, man. You can hear my controllers because I'm going wild on it. I'm a wild man. Come on. This is crazy. Let's do a jump attack. Ready? Boosh! Peace out, snakes. Whoa! That one almost hit me. I think that saturated my nose hairs. Okay, come on. I could start using more fire paper and bolt paper because I have like 30 fire paper right now. I could start doing that. That was not smart. Alright, hey, thanks, buddy. That's just what I wanted. See how this little dance works here. Worked pretty good. I guess getting like medium range right out of their range, like just in. You don't want to be in like their shooting range, but you don't want to be within their melee either. Now I lost track of where I was going. I came around here, it was these guys. Okay. Let's sneak up on this guy. We transform, that way it's longer. Come in, charge attack. Got him. Alright, there we go. Bloodstone chunk, that's what I'm talking about. That's what we need. They were guarding that with their lives, all three of them. three badasses guarding that one chunk. Alright, right wall strats. Nothing there. I thought I saw something. Got a little baby snake. Are you serious? First time I do a running attack and it hits me for the first time. Oh, yeah. Thank you. I could probably wreck these guys with my charge attack before they can even hit me. Yep. Alright, now I got a big snake to deal with. Right there. And a couple of his little butt buddies. Let's deal with the butt buddies first. One down. He's spitting right at the tombstone. That's cool. Oh, for real? Now my shit's not working. Oh, for real? Come on. Wow, that's way longer than I thought. Are you gonna spit? Yep. Oh, not cool. Quit sucking. Quit sucking. There we go. And I'm poisoned. Sweet. That's why you put antidotes on this bar. There we go. Not poisoned. Aren't gonna die. Heal it up. Still got 15 blood vials, so we really haven't used that many. Seems like we have, but we've been gaining them as we go as well. Frenzied cold blood. That's what you were guarding. That kind of sucks. Let's get our torch back out. Do we have our belt on? No. I don't get that thing. Why does it go off? I want to put the lantern on my belt, and I want it to stay forever. There's like no reason to take that thing off, but every time I turn around, it's off again. So I don't know. It must be whenever you load the game or go to a different area, which is the same thing, Cinny. Must take it off your belt whenever you do that type shit. Okay. I kind of want to go back before, you know, the area with the hand cannon and the afflicted beggar and the shortcut. I kind of want to go back before that because I feel like I missed shit back there too. But I'll probably just do that off recording. And if I find anything cool, I'll just record it. That's the only cool thing about the PS4 share function, which is what I use right now. I'm not like a super elite channel yet that uses a computer or anything. I do use a laptop to like do a little bit of editing. And I just started getting my thumbnail game kind of going. It's not 100% there yet, but I'm getting better. And my last video has a decent thumbnail that I worked on. And this one's gonna have one. And you probably already know that. For real? But, oh, serious? I'm trying to do better, guys, basically. Just keep watching. What is this thing? It looks like it came alive or something. What is that? It looks like it has an arm. That's weird. Oh, for real? Where'd you come from? Seriously, man? Alright. Yeah, so, I'm getting better, I promise. And Souls is gonna stick around. It's always gonna be one of the series I'm doing, no matter what. Whether it's speedruns of Dark Souls 2, or challenge runs of this, of Bloodborne, or Dark Souls Remastered. I have it, and I haven't played it yet, because I'm still playing this game. I bought it later than I told you guys I would, but I got it. I do have it. I promise. And I've played it a little bit, but I didn't want to play it too much because I'm going to be doing it for the channel. Are you serious? That should have been a parry. My timing's way off. This guy could fuck me up. Alright, I don't know where all these dudes are coming from, but we're thinning them out. Sucks we only got like 10 minutes left, though. As you can probably tell, I don't do very much editing. I kind of do one take on most stuff. I just started, I wrote a script for my last video. It wasn't a Souls video. But I did it in like 3 takes. And then stuff like this, I just do willy-nilly off the dome. I just leave, unless I accidentally say something crazy, then I'll edit that out. But that's only happened like one time. If any. I can't even remember. Man, I feel like I need to go kill all those snakes, but I want to keep going with the right wall strats. Alright, whatever. We need to hurry. I only got like 8 minutes left. Since I had to include the shortcut in at the beginning, it kind of stole 5 minutes from us here. Plus, I'm trying to be more careful because I've had a couple mishaps with my videos going too long here recently, which sucks. Because then I gotta like cut off important stuff. Or it just becomes a mess, basically. It's way hard to edit for me if I screw up my timing. But yeah, I've learned how to do thumbnails now, pretty much. Like, I'm very new at it. I've done one that I'm proud of. And like two that I'm proud of, including this one and the one before this. And then I've made a couple other that were like beginner attempts at it that were decent. So I'm getting better, and I think I'll just keep getting better at it too. And then I did my first video with like a script and like an idea that I, you know, came up with a new series and whatnot. And I did research and everything. So this is gonna be, I'm gonna be doing Souls, you know. I started talking about how all the Souls dudes are MIA right now, it seems. Like, EMB and Lobos Jr. are like playing anything these days. Final Fantasy and Persona. They're not playing Souls games anymore. LP Dark Souls HD, he's like gone. He's been gone for like 4 months, at least. I remember him saying he got a new job or something, and it was taking up like almost all of his time. Tons of work hours, you know. And who else is there? Fighting Cowboy. Vaddy Vidya, he's still around, but his videos are different than like I would make. He does like news, more like news, you know, and lore. And then Sunlight Blade, he just started coming back a little bit, but he does top tens. I'm just doing playthroughs. And I know like some of the normal big YouTubers do Souls games like once, like when they're new. But they don't go very deep in, and they just kind of do what I'm doing this time and just get through the game without doing anything extra. So I'm kind of hoping to fill the hole that like LP Dark Souls HD left behind. He's got like 50,000 subscribers, and I would love to have that many. If everybody from that channel came over here, that'd be great. Sharp Bloodstone. Alright, 5 minutes. Well, that sucks, because we didn't really get very much done. We kind of just went along the right wall and picked up a bunch of stuff. Don't really feel like we got anything significant, except for a couple of runes. What's back here? Is this the dang boss? That'd be sweet. I don't think I can beat him in 5 minutes, though, with... You never know, though. Alright, cool. Let's just go ahead and give it a shot. I got 4 minutes. Let's do it. No, this ain't the boss. Is this another, shortcut? I don't know why I thought that was the boss. But hey, we got a shortcut. That's a good accomplishment. What's up here? I feel like the shortcut was down here somewhere. And there's an item. Cool, we got a shortcut. Clockwise Metamorphosis. Hurry up and read this. So we're running short on time. A secret symbol left by Carol Runesmith of Bergenworth. I need to quit reading that part. The twisted cross means metamorphosis. Rotated clockwise, this rune boosts HP. The discovery of blood made their dream of evolution a reality. Metamorphosis and the accession of deviation that followed were only a beginning. There's more runes than I remember. That's cool. There's resistance, there's HP. I think there's a stamina one, which is kind of like the green crest shield. There's ones that give you extra bullets, extra blood vials. The beasthood ones, those are cool. There's all kinds of ones. I forgot. Forgot about all of them. Forgot there's a stamina boosting one. I don't think we got that one yet, but... Now, isn't this a shortcut? Come on. I thought we had a shortcut coming up. I feel like I missed it or something. I did open a gate. So, how do I get back here? How do we get back here? If I opened a gate, where does the gate go? This is stupid, man. I don't got enough time to figure this out. I opened this gate. Must be another way. Must be back this way. Come on, idiot. You got like 2 minutes, idiot. Come on, bro. Oh, here's a path. Is this the path? I hope so. Okay, where are we? Where's this? Where is this? Come on. Oh no, this is where we came in. Shit. Okay. So I'll go left, I think. Go left up here. I already went that way, right? So if we go this way... I'm hoping this is... This is the boss. Crap. I only got 2 minutes. Are you serious? Oh my god. Okay, I guess we're doing this. Don't get stuck. Alright, got one down. Man, I gotta hurry. Man, that guy's gonna kill me. Are you serious? Come on. Somebody come over and get me. Come get me. Dicks. Come on. Come on. You get me. I gotta figure out where your buddy is. Alright, there he is. Come on. Come here. You know you wanna. Luckily, I left myself an extra 5 minutes. Jeez. Wish I had some, Blood Beast pellets. I would've put them on. Alright. My alarm's going off and everything. Okay, alarm. I know. It's time to get off. One of them's almost dead. One of them's almost dead. Come here. Are you the one that's almost dead? Stop that. Nope, you're not. Okay, you are. And... oh my god, what the fuck? What the fuck was that? Alright, one more bolt paper for the win. What are you doing? Ooh, we got him, y'all. I can't believe that. Blood Rapture. What is Blood Rapture? Well, now that thumbnail's kinda... I had no clue I'd fight the boss, though. Dang it. I might have to make a new thumbnail, y'all. I don't know, though. It could be a nice surprise. Shit. I wanna look at that rune real quick. And then we'll get out of here. What was it? Blood Rapture. A carol rune that transcribes inhuman sounds. Blood Rapture is the raw euphoria of the warmth of blood. Restores HP with visceral attacks, one of the darker hunter techniques. This rune resonates with servants of the queen, carrier of the child of blood, who yearn for their queen's blood with little hope of requitement. For them, they find solace in Blood Rapture, this that serves as a surrogate for their desires. See, that's what I'm talking about. It's not passive. You have to actually do something. You have to do a visceral attack. Where are we going now? Is this Boogerworth? Maybe I can find a lantern real quick. That'd be cool. Get the fuck out of here. I just want a lantern. Here it is. Alright. Oh, thanks, buddy. Oh, that's not cool. I need to get off here, bro. Get off me. Suck it. Suck it down. Deep in your throat. Oh, nice frenzy, thanks. Alright, anyway. That's it for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't. Like if you have. And share and tell a friend, please. Well, that was a surprise, man. I guess I'll still use the same thumbnail, but it'll just be a surprise that I fight the hunters or the Shadows of Yharnam. I don't know. I might put it in the title. Who? I don't know. I did too much work on the thumbnail to change it, though. Anyway. Like, share, subscribe. See y'all next time. Peace.